Again, starting with the finite square well, and we have studied the under this potential the bound states, and now we will be starting with the scattering states. So the scattering states, we will have to take energy is positive, it will be no more bound, and again in step one, we will solve the Schrodinger wave equation, and the Schrodinger wave equation solution I will now not go very step by step here. We have done this many times. So to solve this one, the, for the region when x is less than minus a, so we are having no potential, v of x will be equal to 0, and we will have the solution in form of exponential is psi of x equal to a e I k x plus b e minus I k x, where k is, we have supposed earlier, will be 2 m e square root by h bar. Similarly, when x is greater than plus a, again we are having v of x equal to 0, and psi of x will be equal again to the same thing but with different constants, and f, it will be f e I k x plus g e to the power minus I k x. But as we know that there are no incidence, there is no incidence from this side, so we will have to take this component equal to 0, and only this will survive with plus k x. F e plus I k x, y g e minus I k x, so there is no incidence from this side, and due to this reason we will have only f e I k x. Similarly, when x is between plus and minus a, then we know that we are having the potential equal to minus v naught, and this gives us the solution psi of x equals, I will write this one in form of exponential for applying the boundary condition, it is, so this is c sine lx plus d cos lx. And we know about L that L is equal to 2m v naught plus e square root by h bar. So we will have the solution of the Schrodinger wave equation in step one like this. Now we know that a here is the amplitude of incoming waves, and the incoming waves are actually from the left. So incoming waves from left, while b is the amplitude of reflected waves. These are the reflected, while f is the amplitude of the transmitted waves. Those waves which will transmit through the well, the amplitude of it will be equal to f, and this is equal to this one. Now another fact that we know, that our scattering problem is actually asymmetric, because here we are using exponential error to apply the boundary condition easily, while here we are using the sine and cosine. This is just for the purpose of applying the boundary condition at ease, means we will derive the thing easily. The asymmetric nature is from here, that we are having no incidence from here. So this is only the transmitted amplitude. So we got the solution in this form, that psi of x is equal to this, psi of x equal this, and psi of x equal this in the potential region. And now we will have to apply the boundary condition. So let me write the psi is in a simplified form. Psi of x is equal to a e I k x plus b e minus I k x for x less than minus a, and this is c sine l x plus d cos l x, and this is for minus a less than x less than plus a, and this is equal to f e I k x for x greater than plus a. So we are having our psi equal to this. Now we will have to in step two we will have to apply the boundary conditions. Now the boundary conditions are, the very first one is that psi is continuous at plus a, and psi is continuous, two condition will give that psi is continuous. Is continuous at minus a, then the same will be true for the derivative of this, like d psi over dx is continuous at plus a, and 4 will be d psi over dx is continuous at minus a. So we will have to apply these boundary conditions. Now if I consider psi at plus a, and the condition 1 will actually imply that, means when I will apply 1, so here I am, means the wave function on this side is, means the wave function on this side will be the same. This is the x equal to plus a boundary. So the wave function on this side at x equal to plus a and on this side will be the same, and this will give that c sine of l a. So I will, means on the x both sides, c sine of l a plus d cos of la is equal to this one, f e I k a, while sine at minus a, the two boundary condition will apply, means when x is equal to minus a, so we will have this situation, that the wave function on this side will be equal to the wave function on this side. So we will have minus C sine LA, because when x is minus A, then minus will come out, plus D cos LA. The minus will not come out as cos is even. This will be A e to the power, because on that side we are having the wave function equal to this. So minus IKA plus B e to the power plus IKA. And similarly, the third condition means the d psi over dx, when x is equal to plus a, at x equals a, it will give us, means the third boundary condition will give, we will have to take derivative of this one now, and to take the derivative of this one, what will happen? C, and this will be cos LA and then L. So we will have C L, so let me take common the L and then C cos LA. Then it will be minus sine LA and L will be here, so minus D sine LA, and this whole is then equal, take the derivative of this one, so it will be I K and F E I K A. Similarly, the last boundary condition, d psi over dx at x minus a, the fourth boundary condition will apply, that take the derivative of this one now, and it will be from this one, is we will put x equal to minus a, so this it will come out to be, if I take L is common, then take the derivative of this one, it will be cos LA, L will come out, so I have taken it as common, and then I will put x equal minus a, so it will be c cos LA, c cos LA, and then plus it will be 1 minus is here, 1 minus is here, so it will be minus d sine LA, so from 1 minus from here will make this positive, and it will be d sine LA, and take L as a whole common, and then it will be equal to, let me take IK common, if I take IK common, then and for A I will put minus, for X I will put minus A, so it will be AE minus IKA plus B IK. So we have got a set of four equations, and if I look here, then we are having how many constants? A, B, C, D. So four constants are there, and four equations will be sufficient for it. But we are having F as well. So it means five unknown and four constants, four equations. So we cannot find the values of these constants, because the number of equations are less than the number of unknowns. So what we can do, we will have to find the transmission coefficient in terms of the incident coefficient, while the reflected coefficient in terms of incident. So what we will do now, we will treat with these equations, and to treat with this equation, let me write this is equation 1, this one is equation 2, this is equation 3, and this one is equation 4. So what we will do, we will find B in terms of A. So it will be the reflected coefficient in terms of the incident, and we will find F in terms of A, the transmitted coefficient in terms of the incident coefficient or amplitude. So we will then write that the transmission is equal to the coefficient square, F coefficient square, which is the amplitude, and the incident coefficient square, while the reflection will be B square over A squared. So we will have to find these. Now we will have to treat these equations such that we can find the transmission and the reflection coefficients, because the transmission and the reflection, because here we are considering the scattering states and E is greater than 0, and there will be no bound states here. There will be transmission and reflection, while the wave will not get bound with this potential because we are having a positive energy. And when E is positive, no bound states will be there. The bound state we have already discussed when E was less than 0.